Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hello, good morning to everyone and welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering Lecture. Myself, Professor Dr. Mahadev Unde, Professor, Electrical Engineering Department, Jheel College of Engineering and Research, Pune. In this video lecture, we are going to solve few numericals based on Thevenin's theorem. Let's start now. The numerical has been already shown here. See, it has been asked to find the current flowing through AB, means these two points, that is flowing through 4 ohm resistance by using the Thevenin's theorem, TT. So, as per the theory, we have to go step by step, we have to follow the three steps. So accordingly, let's have the step one. To find phi OC equal to phi AB equal to phi TH, remove 4 ohm resistance. And read all the circuit. Say this point is A, this point is B, say this is 3 ohm, this is 2 ohm, this one is 10 volt. Now here it is, this is 6 ohm, this one is 3 ohm, this is also 3 ohm, and this battery voltage is 12 volt. Okay, so these are the two points which we have shown separately in order to remember that we have to find out voltage across these two points A and B. Okay, here are two closed paths and we have to find the current flowing through them so that we can find the phi AB. So generally current is delivered from the positive terminal of the battery generally, and therefore let us have the direction of currents like this. Say this is I1 and say this is I2. Okay, so what is the I1? I1 equal to 12 divided by 6, and this is equal to 2 ampere. Similarly, here I2 equal to 10 divided by 5, 3 plus 2, 5, equal to 2 ampere. Okay, then phi AB travel from B to A, travel from B to A. See, B to A, say this point is say C and this point is say D. Okay, so let us go from B to C. B to C, when we are going in the direction of current, there is falling potential. Falling potential is negative sign. So this two resistance, 2 multiplied by I2, 2 multiplied by I2. What is I2? I2 is also 2 ampere. Okay, then there is no flow of current flowing through this CD, therefore plus 6 into 0, the current is 0. Then D to A, we are going in opposite direction to that of the I1, and therefore there is rise in potential. Rise in potential is positive sign. So plus 3 I1. So what is I1? I1 is also 2 ampere. So this is equal to minus 4 plus 0 plus 6 equal to 2. Okay, then the step 2, to find Ri equal to Rth, make the circuit passive, make the network passive. That is, if there are voltage sources, we have to short circuit them, and if the current sources are there, we can open circuit there. So therefore, now the circuit will be like this. This is 3, this is 3, this is 6, this is 3, this is 2, and this is A, B, and we have written this as a C and D. Okay. Now if you observe carefully, this 3 and 3 are in parallel, and this 3 and 2 are also in parallel. Therefore, this circuit will become like this. This is A, this is 3, this is 2, 3, 3, this one is 6. See, 3 and 3 parallel, that will become 3 and 3 parallel, that is 1.5, this is point A, then this is point D, this is C, and 3 parallel 2, 3 into 2 divided by 5, that is 1.2. So this is point A, 1.5, 6, 1.2. Therefore, Ri equal to RAB equal to RTH equal to 8.7 ohm. Okay? See, remember that we have to go on reducing the circuit towards AB. We have to go on reducing the circuit towards AB. So, this is your Ri. So, the operation, you should reach to point A and B. So, between A and B, there is 8.7 ohm. Now, the step 3. To find IL, reconnect RL. So Thevenin's voltage this is 4 ohm, this is how much? 8.7, and this is 2 volt. Therefore, IL equal to 2 divided by 8.7 plus 4 equal to 2 divided by 8.7 how much it is? Two divided by 8.7 plus 4, 0.157. So this is the answer. As answer is positive, that means current is flowing from A to B. Okay, IL. Current is flowing from A to B. Answer is positive. You can verify this answer. Directly apply the KVL here. There will be three loops. And you will get the solution directly. Which current you have to find out? 4 ohm. Means you have to see if it is here I1, here it is I2, here it is I3. Then you have to find out I2. You will get the same solution. You can check at home. Okay. Let's have the one more numerical based on this, which has been already depicted here. So find the current flowing through AB using the TT. So AB is here 4 ohm resistance. Okay. So this circuit is also similar to previous one. Solution. Step 1. To find phi TH equal to phi AB. Remove 4 ohm. Therefore, the circuit becomes this is 12. This is 3 and this one is 100 ohm. Okay. Now here say this is I1. Okay. So minus 12 I1 minus 3 I1 plus 15 plus 100 equal to 0. So minus 15 I1 equal to minus 150. Therefore I1 equal to 150 divided by 15 means 10 ampere. Okay. On solving the question, answer is positive. That means assume the direction is correct or actual one. Therefore, phi AB travel from B to A. Travel from B to A. You can go from point B via 100 volt or via 50 volt. You will get the same solution. Let us have. Now see, let us go by 100 volt. So, if you reach negative terminal of the battery first, it will be plus 100. Okay. Now while traveling like this, see via this way, so we are going in the direction of current. In the direction of current, there is fall in potential. So 12 into 10, it is equal to minus 20. Or VAB equal to travel from B to A via 50 volt battery. From B to while going in anti-clockwise direction, we reach positive terminal of the battery first, therefore minus 15. And we are going in opposite direction to that of the voltage, to that of the current, and therefore plus 3 into 10. So it will be minus 24. So you can go by any means, you will get the same solution. Okay. So here it is, we have obtained the phi TH. Step 2, to find RR, make the circuit passive. Therefore, here it is A. Say it is shorted, so it will become like this. As it is shorted, this will become 12 ohm and this is 3. So RAB equal to RI equal to 12 parallel 3. 36 divided by 15, and that is equal to 2.4 ohm. Step 3. To find IL, reconnect RL equal to 4 ohm. Okay, so here it is, the VTH is minus 20, indicates that it will be like this. This is B and this one is 4. This is 2.4. Okay, so current will deliver from this. So IL equal to VTH upon RTH plus RL. So it is 20 divided by 2.4 plus 4. This is equal to 20 divided by 6.4. It is 3.125 amperes. On solving the question, see here it is, or otherwise you will get, if you consider, I have considered it like this, see the direction of current, so it is positive. You can go by any means. See, you can start from this point, say this is P and this is say Q, so you can reach the same point again. See, P to B, there is no question. Then here it is minus 4i, minus 2.4i, then plus 20 equal to 0. So, minus 6.4i equal to minus 20, therefore I equal to 20 divided by 6.4 equal to 3.125 amperes. That is B to A. Current is flowing from B to A. Okay. So in this way, we have solved the two more numericals in this video lecture. I hope there would be no difficulty. I will stop here. Thank you. Thank you very much.